Instagram friends, it's Amber from AmberPlansHerDay, and I'm coming on to share a new brush pen that I found on Amazon. Well, not exactly me. I did not find these on Amazon. I saw Diana from That's What She Planned. I'll have her socials linked below. She was using these, and I was like, that looks like an amazing brush pen. So, of course, I ordered it, right? Like, why wouldn't I have ordered it? Did I order just one pack? Of course I did not order just one pack. We got all three packs here. We have Vintage Color, Vibrant Color, and Natural Color. I always find these smaller nibbed brush pens to be really amazing when you're just starting out brush lettering. And a lot of these are great in your planner and all of those things. So let's go ahead and kind of start. Guess we're going to start with the Vintage Color pack, which is fine with me. These colors look beautiful. Whoops. Good thing I don't really keep things in boxes, right? I really don't want you to do that. I want you to all come out at the same time. Thank you. Okay, this looks so pretty. I guess we'll just kind of take them off anyway, right? Like, I'm not going to stay on here. Okay, so let's put these colors on the side. I have just a Happy Planner filler page here, and I want to show you guys all the colors, of course, and share with you, yeah, these new brush pens that probably aren't like new, but so I want to write the brand probably at the top. As you can see, the brush nib is very little. Let me make sure you guys can see that it's like focusing. Focus. Very small nib. Okay, so then I want to write Writech up here. Oh, this is so nice. Writech. Writech. Just pick a different color, right? Like, might as well. Sign. Dang. It's gonna take a minute to dry. I can already tell you that. Sign pen. Which is fine. Sometimes that happens with pens. You just need to let them dry. So far, really no shadowing. You can see where I dotted the I and crossed the T there. But for pen, you can't really see any. And for the most part, you really can't see any. And if it's like laid down like that, you can see even less. But you can see the dots there. And I probably just wrote a little bit too rough, which is pretty normal for me. Sometimes I write a little bit rough. So, I'm just going to kind of do like a little sample of each color. So you can see even how they write. And then the less pressure you do when you go up and more pressure when you come down. Ooh, that color's really pretty. How many are there? 12, right? So I'm just gonna do 6 down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They always say to practice your drills. So if you guys are curious about lettering, then that's kind of what I recommend. Say worried about smearing these ones here, but I think it'll be okay. So this is the Vintage pack here. I'm loving these colors. These colors are like just beautiful. Just a few more, some blues. As a lefty, sometimes people ask me, how do I brush letter. And it is a lot of practice, but something that I do like, and I didn't really do it up here, but sometimes it depends how you like angle your paper as well. So like right now it's angled so much that I wasn't really going right over it. And then I want to write here. I don't really care. Just vintage. Okay, so then that's the vintage pack. Now, like, I don't want to get these mixed up though, you know what I mean? So kind of put those over there, I think. Now we do have a vibrant and a natural. Let's go with natural next, I think. See how this color goes. Sometimes I just think these are, oh, these are gonna be so fun to play around with in your planner and all of those things. Okay, so these colors definitely look different. Is this a black one? Okay, I don't know. But we are going to skip a line here, and then we'll kind of just, I'll probably skip a couple. So then you guys can see the difference here. I mean, it doesn't really matter what, which way I go. Let's see here. I'll probably write some like words with you guys as well. This is a really beautiful like blue navy kind of color. Let's see, kind of like an olive. Loving the olive color too. Ooh, I like this pack. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, last one before we kind of go to the next section over here. So this one again is the natural pack. And I'll have all of these linked. I got all of these on Amazon, so that'll be great option if you guys are online shoppers like me. That one I smeared a little bit. Oh, this one's like a light color. Oh, I really like that one too. Almost like a highlighter. Hey, don't get stuck on me. Okay, now this is the one I was curious about. Is this going to be a black? It is black. These, the smaller the nib, like the way nicer it is to write in your planner, because you actually have the time, like the space to write in those little brush pens. So this one's natural. 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 Okay. And then based on what we see here, the pens are like the same exact. Like there's not really going to be a way to tell what pack they came from if you store them together. So I may want to store them somewhat separately just to kind of keep the color separate. Sometimes the way that I think about it is sometimes colors are put together for a reason. And if you guys ever have like a hard time choosing color palettes, sometimes keeping your pen separated is a great start for that. Now, don't get me wrong, I haven't always been like that, but it is a really good place to kind of start because you're not going to be using like, I mean, you could use it, but you're most likely not going to be using some of those vintage colors with some of these brighter colors. Now, I want to be bad, right? Like I think like even like something like that blue and that green might go together, but for me it is almost like a little bit different. I wouldn't necessarily use them 100% together. I love the gray, beautiful gray color. This is a really bright yellow, so way different than some of those other yellows. And then, oh my gosh, that pink. These are definitely a lot more vibrant, and you can tell even like just compared to the other markers how much brighter these are. See, now I almost take it back. Like the, like it wouldn't look bad together, but look how bright and vibrant it is compared. Oh, I think I like this. Have I said that every single time? It's like, I think I like this pack the best. I think I like this pack the best. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Just like you can definitely tell kind of the difference in these colors here. So stinking pretty. Okay. Then last two here. Oh my goodness, that color's beautiful. I like that one a lot. And then this one is another bright pink. I'll be curious to see the difference. So this one's a little bit brighter, and that one's a little bit less, a little bit duller, but they're both really vibrant colors. I think this one was my favorite from that pack. Vibrant. Vibrant. Okay. So those are the three packs that I bought. They're all available on Amazon. This is a really nice brush pen. The brush, although it is little, it is very like flexible. So you can see even, oh, not like that. When you kind of just put the marker down, it kind of just automatically thickens up as you lay it down. Kind of making a little flower there. Let's see. Let me show you guys with another color too. So I kind of want to show you in a comparison compared to some other brush pens, specifically this brush pen, the Zebra Mild Liner brush pen. Let me get kind of a darker color so you can see. So as you can see, look at that brush pen compared to the one that I literally just did. This one, while it, look at this flower, it's gonna be so stinking cool. So cool and so pretty. But look at the size of that flower compared to the size of this flower. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's going to be a lot littler because the brush pen is a lot smaller. So whenever you're thinking about nibs, which is what like the tip of that brush pen is called, you can even just think about when you lay it out flat and you put your pressure on it, how big is that space going to be? Because that space is massive. Compared, like, look at this downstroke. You can make it so massive because of how big that nib is, which is really fun to write with as well. But sometimes whenever you have like the smaller pens, it's just a little bit easier to hand letter with. So I do want to grab one more piece of paper. And I want to use, I think I'm going to use these vibrant colors. I just love this color so much. So I kind of want to let her enjoy and then we'll put the dot up there. Enjoy. And then I want to say every, I think. Oh, Echo, stop it. Every. And then let's go for one of those blue ones. Day. Now look at how stinking fun that is. It's like, wow, those colors are so vibrant. If I did something like in the vintage palette, like I can just do something smaller. Love. Every. So this is a similar, it's purple, but just such a different color purple. Every. Now that one did not turn out as good. I didn't have enough space, but I like that pink color too. So like, depending kind of what vibes you like, you can even just buy one pack and just get such a different variety of colors and styles in this book. Also to note, one of my favorite words, this is from the natural pack, to practice lettering is hello, because I feel like it has a bunch of different strokes available and some different loops and just some different curves. You can letter it so different every single time. So this is like one of my go-to practice words. If you guys are ever like wondering, I have a feeling it's most people's practice word. Here's one from the Vibrant Pack, but I'm always practicing hello. And I feel like you can just do it so differently. Like you can like make it more bouncy by just like changing how you write, and like it just can be different every single time. I personally like, I like to have a little bit of bounce, but like some people just are able to do it so amazing, and that's not me. But you can like, you can even with brush pens, you can even go like this, right? You can go like and make some of these different font types and just like experiment with different things, different styles, and just different how you write. Like this is how I would normally write. How are you? Like that's how I would normally write. Now granted, I smeared it. But like you can even just write like a regular pen with this and still get just a lot of different style and a lot of different variety. And I just think that this pen is such a good basic brush pen. So again, you guys, I do want to shout out Diana. She shared these pens on her Instagram page. That's what she planned, and I'll have it linked down below. And I just love it. One, so many beautiful colors, but also the way that the nib is, this is, I'm super excited. I'm just super, super excited. So definitely check these out if you're new to brush pen, brush lettering, or just want to experiment and see kind of how you can add this to your pen lineup. Because let's be real, we all love our pens, and this one is definitely a great choice. Check out the Amazon link down below and let me know what you guys think about these pens.